Hi, welcome to Pleasure Sports. I'm excited to show you the new Psycho 2 for 2011 Fall 2012. The Psycho 2 has a major upgrade this year. O'Neill has actually used what's called 3XDS Ultraflex Neoprene throughout the entire wetsuit. It is a low density, lightweight, super stretch neoprene, and it's actually utilized throughout the entire suit. The chest panel is a little bit different material, and I'll go through that in a little bit. But what we have here in the Psycho 2 is a 4.3mm, 4mm thickness of neoprene in the core body, 3mm neoprene in the arms and shoulders where you need to do most of your paddling and your stretching and your sport and moving around. And it also comes in this 4.3 and this 3.2 version. 3.2 has 3mm in the core, 2mm in the arms and shoulders, identical in construction. And what you're seeing is that we've turned the 3.2 inside out, and again, they're identical. So this is so that you can see the inside of the wetsuit, and I'll go through those features in just a minute. The key about the Psycho 2 is the double weld, and what that means is along every seam of this wetsuit, it has first been glued together, the two pieces of neoprene, and then a blind stitch. And a blind stitch does not penetrate both pieces of neoprene, so you already have a watertight seal with just the GBS, the glued and blind stitching. And then O'Neill went ahead and put a single weld on the exterior of all the seams. And if you look on the inside where you don't see a weld here along the neck, you'll see the weld on the interior here. So you've got a double weld on the exterior of the suit and the interior. And that's what makes it the Psycho 2. It's double weld. And this makes this suit incredibly durable and watertight. It's one of the warmest wetsuits on the market. In fact, it has won Wetsuit of the Year multiple times. So let's take a look, a little bit closer look at the key features of the suit and show you what you're getting for your money. We first talked about that super stretch neoprene. So along with that super stretch neoprene, we've got an amazing anatomically cut design throughout this wetsuit. So this wetsuit was actually cut in panels to anatomically fit your calves, your knees, pre-bent arms, the wraparound waist area of the body, and I'll show you the backside here in a minute. And what this actually does is it prevents water from pooling in the suit because it's actually fitting nice and snug. Therefore, you stay a lot warmer and more comfortable, and you don't get as exhausted working against too much material, not cut properly to fit the body. So it's a really great design. On the exterior of the wetsuit, you'll see the knee pads. These are crypto knee pads. These are abrasion resistant material. On the back of the right leg, you have an exterior key pocket, and that's also welded. So you can put your key on this loop, slip it through, and then stick it back up in the hole, and you can use that as a nice little stash pocket. On the back side of the wetsuit and on the front side of the wetsuit, on the chest here, what you have here is a neoprene that actually has air in it. And what O'Neill's gone out and done is they've made they went to extents to actually make it warmer in the chest to keep your organs nice and warm. And what they've done is they've used an air-infused neoprene, and equivalent to like double pane windows in your home that actually keep you nice and warm. You've got air put in between the cells of the neoprene here in the chest to keep it lighter and yet make it even more warm for you in the suit. So you've got that along the front body, and you've got that along the lower back to protect the kidneys. And this material is actually called O'Neill's XDS Air Firewall, and it's fantastic. So that's the external portion of the material where you can actually see close up the little dents where the air is inside the neoprene. And if you look at the inside of the laminate of that portion of your suit, and what we're looking at here is the back, so we can see it here along the back. This is actually the firewall material laminated onto the XDS Air Firewall. And what this actually does is it actually is thermal insulating, so it actually is heat retaining. So when it heats up, when you heat up or the sun hits it, it stays warm. And it's also really light and also wicks away water. It's a really wonderful feature in the suit. Again, on the interior of the suit, you'll see that secondary seam weld along all the seams, all the way down the legs and the knees on the backside, and it's really beautifully done. This particular wetsuit, the Psycho 2, has a beautifully tapered ankle seals and wrist seals. They're low profile. You've got this liquid seam strip around the ankles as well as in the wrists. And this actually prevents the suit from blowing out. So we can imagine we got to put our hand in there all the time. And if we kept doing that and doing that, eventually it would just stretch out and stay stretched out, and water would eventually be able to pool up into your suit and you would get cold. And these little strips and this, the way this was sewn back and given a lip, actually helps keep the durability of the wrist and ankle seals. The wrist seals have that stitch back, and this has the tapering, and it's really beautiful, low profile, and really comfortable on the skin, and a great feature also on the suit. It helps keep the wrist in place, also keeps the ankle seals in place. This particular wetsuit has a patent pending, it's called a ZenZip entry, and that's this flap here, so it's actually patented. It's a zip enclosure, and what it actually is when you go, and we'll look at the back side of your wetsuit here, you have a nice adjustable collar. And you'll see the ZenZip entry right here. So what we do is we take it off the hanger there. And this ZenZip entry, it's got a short zipper on the back. And so why we have a short zipper on the back of this wetsuit is the shorter the zipper is on the wetsuit, the more stress you're going to get out of the material. If you have a rigid zipper all the way down to low back, your neoprene can't stretch any more than this plastic zipper. So only having an upper back allows you to really have a lot of flexibility in the lower back. And this ZenZip entry is another barrier to prevent water from flushing through the zipper. So you've got a water-resistant zipper here, and then you've got another secondary barrier of neoprene, which is probably a 3mm neoprene. And if water were to get past the zipper and hit the ZenZip closure, it would actually drain out of this little pinhole. So basically what you've got is a really great way to stay super warm, and if you go under waves or if you're splashing around in the water, that you're not getting these floods down your back, because what you have here is a barrier that goes over your head and also creates another seal around your neck. And that's what this is right here that you're seeing on the interior backside. You're seeing the backside of that ZenZip closure. See how nice and warm and toasty your wetsuit is. A lot of features in this wetsuit. It's understandable why it won Wetsuit of the Year. If you look at the interior of this wetsuit around the neck, you have a roll skin neoprene. This helps prevent rashing and that choking sensation that can happen with wetsuits. So you've got a nice cut in this design, anatomically cut design, and you've got a great choice of material, and the glide skin actually creates a seal between your neck and the glide skin neoprene. So again, helping to prevent flushing. As I said before, a short zip here, which is amazing, and an adjustable collar as well. You've got no seams in the lower lumbar here section. If there was a seam here in manufacturing, likelihood would be that as your legs are moving apart and stretching this way, you would split that seam and you would create a seam or a hole that would allow water to flush in. So the fact that there's one nice piece of neoprene here with no seam is also great design. Again, looking at the longevity of your purchase to make sure that you've got a wetsuit that's constructed well and it's built to last. So this is a jam-packed feature packed wetsuit. If I've missed anything on the wetsuit, you can learn more about the Psycho 2 in the 4.3mm or the 3.2 at pleasuresports.com. We've got one thing I want to show you also. We've got a boot that is often purchased with this wetsuit. You can find boots and accessories on our website in the left navigation. The O'Neill Heat is a great boot for this wetsuit. It comes in a 7mm, a 5mm, and a 3mm. And it's just a super durable boot. It has that firewall interior water wicking material on the inside of the boot. It's got a great seal at the top of the boot so that you don't get those elephant ankles. You can actually control to make sure water doesn't over pool in your boot and you don't feel like you're carrying around big heavy boots. And you've also got another strap over the top that actually gives you a lot of arch support. And you've got great rubber coming up and over the boots. They didn't spare any material here. And actually to protect the durability of the neoprene so that your boots can last season after season after season. So it's a great boot with great support, a great little lip here, and they're called the O'Neill Heat, and you can get them in 5, 4, 5, 7, and 3mm at pleasuresports.com.